Go live? Did you say go live? Go live? Hello, everyone. Thank you for all of your wonderful patience and being here, and happy Black History Month. Okay, beautiful. So we're just going to get started here. And I would like to introduce everybody here today. And if you would like to write one word that represents Black excellence to you, so you can either use your phone and text Lena Hall 771 to 37607 to join, or you can go to paulev.com/LenaHall771 and type in one word that represents Black excellence.
Thank you to the ranking member from Arkansas. I thank Mr. Stauber for working with me on several amendments that protect Colorado's 3rd Congressional District. All 11 of my amendments were denied to give voice to the people in my district. Mr. Speaker, this bill targets my district and would lock up more than 550,000 acres of it with new wilderness designations. The Mesa County Commissioners, Montezuma County Commissioners, Dolores County Commissioners, Archuleta County Commissioners, White River and Douglas Creek Conservation Districts, the Colorado Farm Bureau, and numerous other constituencies in Colorado strongly oppose this bill because of the damage they know that it will cause and activities it will prevent. Mr. Speaker, I will be submitting several of those letters of opposition for the Congressional congressional record. Democrats have ignored our local communities and their needs with this land grab. In their letter of opposition, Mesa County points out 3 of the 5 wilderness areas in Mesa County in this bill have had large fires in recent years, and that wilderness designations harm active management of wildfire activities. I hope that when members visit my district on horseback, they are telling people that this land will soon burn, because if we do not actively manage our forest, Mother Nature will continue to manage it for us.
The amendment
Inclusion and Isolation. And it is brought to you by Vibe, also known as Voices in Black Exit. So we are an Ontario youth-led platform for Black high school students to learn shared histories, create, empower, and enact change in our education. So this year's Black History Month has been brought to you by these lovely people that you see here. We have Shaquana, Carice, Sumaya, Sarah, Jenilyn, Sumaya, and some that you don't see, Priscilla, and Muna.
And the support of communities back home.
We acknowledge we are hosted on the lands of the Mississaugas of the Anishinaabe, the Haudenosaunee Confederacy, and the Wendat. We also recognize the enduring presence of all First Nations, Métis, and Inuit peoples.
This as a land grab is deeply disrespectful to those who have worked long and hard.
Belonging is having the right personal or social qualities to be a member for a particular group. Belonging is having the right to be classified in or assigned to a specified category. Belonging is the right to feel safe and respected.
Hello, everyone. I'm Kudu Mutamba. I am a senior student from Alpha 2 Alternative, and I am here to present to you our guest speaker, Ahmed Monika. First, I'm going to play you all a song on the traditional instrument from Zimbabwe known as Imbira. Ahmed Monika arrived in Toronto from Baghdad 5 years ago and has since collaborated with many artistic institutions. He's one of the founders of the band Mosquito Bar and is the creator and leader of Monika Arabic Jazz, a 2019 Stingray Rising Stars winner at Toronto Jazz Festival. In Baghdad, Ahmed studied theater at the prestigious Academy of Fine Art. During his formative years, he also learned Afro-Sufi singing and drumming in the tradition of his family, who came to Iraq from Kenya in the 8th century. He is the first Black Iraqi to host a television program, the youngest member of the Iraqi National Theater, and he played Romeo in Romeo and Juliet in Baghdad at the Royal Shakespeare Company in England. He starred in the film The Society, which premiered at the Toronto International Film Festival, and resulted in his exile from Iraq because of its subject matter of homosexuality. Ahmed says, "Love is the main reason for a great future." Thank you.
Thank you, Kuda. And now I formally introduce Mr. Ahmed Monika. The floor is yours.
Thank you so much. Good morning. It's so nice to be here with you, and hopefully I will like inspire you in a good way. My name is Ahmed Monika, as you heard, and I'm from Iraq, Baghdad. I have been here in Canada 5 years. I born in Baghdad and I grew up there. And also, you know, as a Black artist, I faced a little bit of difficulties at the beginning, but with my family support, with my friend support, I did a lot of achievement. And that is like driven, when you're driven with love and you have compassion, you become really strong. And that helped me with a connection with my family and with the roots of my family. And I become a tree strong in a state of leaf. And then after all the success in Baghdad, I moved in Toronto in 2015. I was forced to stay here in order to save my life. And I don't know how to speak any word of English at the beginning. So I had to shift my career from an actor to a musician to be able and capable to communicate with people here and to share with them where I came from and how I'm proud of being from Baghdad and Iraq. And during these years here, I learned a lot of things. I learned from a lot of my friends how to share their culture and in which shape that could vibrate with people here in Canada. So we co-found Mosquito Bar. It's a multicultural band to bridge our culture with each other, because this is our strength when we come together and reunite and harmonize and we collaborate with love. And in this case was for me in the music. And also I collaborated with a lot of beautiful artists and amazing artists. And one of them was Sultan of the Trinks. And you will hear in my dreams, if that's okay to go to hear it. Thank you so much. Last sentence I want to say, keep going. Don't give up. Like, take care of your dreams and focus about your targets. Past is analyzing, future is vision, and the most important thing is the moment. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Wanika. And you have a very beautiful story, even though it has its struggles, and beautiful music. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
We will now have a poem recital from our MC from before, Amal Aperman. This is called Letter to My Daughter. Letter to My Daughter is a spoken word poem shared about her mother's journey to Canada, although she's telling from her mother's perspective. Like most, Amal's mother is one of many that would do anything for their child. So this is her way of honoring her mother and acknowledging the struggles her mother has faced and the sacrifices she has made to make her life better.
Dear baby girl, you broke my heart and crushed my dreams. I remember how your youthful eyes gleamed with a look that seemed to scream adoration. You sat on my lap, your head resting on my shoulder, and you said to me, Mom, I want to be like you when I'm older. My heart fell with disappointment, eyes filled with tears as you spoke my worst fear, and so here, I'm writing to you this letter in hopes of getting you to see why you shouldn't want to be like me, because you can be better. Better than me, who at the age of 16 had to flee the country to survive the war, who walked for miles till my feet were bloody and sore and I couldn't walk anymore. Better than me, who arrived in a country where my academic abilities made me a victim of hostility. Better than me, who got pushed around by kids the same skin color as me because they believed that I may be somebody they never thought they could be. Better than me, who came to the true north strong and free with a dream of attaining a degree, only to find out that freedom was never meant for me. I was meant to work from 9 to 5, making just enough to keep me alive. Society made it hard to strive, but I survived the national plague of discrimination, exploitation of refugees, a life filled with tragedies, but my blood, sweat, and tears, they could take it, because I knew one day you would make it, better than me, farther than me. Baby girl, the world lays at your feet, so never accept defeat. And your dreams, you shall meet. Love, Mama.
Resistance, the refusal to accept or comply with something. Thank you, Amal, so much for your beautiful, beautiful piece. And we can't wait to hear even more from you. Priscilla is actually the one speaking right now, but she can't be with us today. So I'll be speaking her part for her. Resistance. Resistance is power. Resistance is joy. Resistance is showing up, is speaking out. Resistance is beauty.
Juxtaposing the Black Boy and the Bullet. By Dana Smith. One is hard and the other tried to be. One is fast and the other was faster. One is loud and one is a song with one note and endless rest. One's whole life is a flash. Both spend their life trying to find a warmth to call home. Both spark quite the debate. Some folks want to protect them and some think we should get rid of the damn things altogether.
Now we will be speaking about allyship. It is the continuous process in which someone with privilege and power seeks to first learn about the experiences of a marginalized group of people, and then ultimately empathize with their challenges and build relationship with that group of people.
So there are different types of allies. There is true, which is the unselfish alignment between values, actions, and risk-taking advocacy. There is secret, which is the value sharing or advocacy only expressed in private conversations or messages. Performative, which is the unsustaining virtues and gestures lacking in measurable and sustaining action. There is lazy, which is the belief values unbacked by further learning actions or risk-taking advocacy. And finally, there is opportunistic, which is the words and actions used only in moments of crisis when participating may have some gain.
A good ally isn't focused on whether they're looking like a good ally. They're focused on showing up in allyship to people of color and not wondering about, am I going to be seen? Am I going to be rewarded? Social media can sometimes perpetuate performative or optical allyship because people feel like if I share this Instagram post or Twitter thread, that's me doing anti-racism work. Anti-racism work is taking a deep dive within first, really uncovering how you perpetuate white supremacy and then creating change from within. Posts can be helpful because people can learn about things that they may not be aware of, but people can get really self-satisfied from that place. We see these things that happen in the media, such as the hashtag #OscarsSoWhite, where the Oscars are being called out for essentially not having enough people of color.
Well, I'm here at the Academy Awards. Otherwise known as the White People's Choice Awards.
You will see well-meaning white people get behind that, pointing the finger outwards essentially, but not looking within their own community and looking within themselves and asking, how am I adding to this fact that everywhere in every industry, the majority of people who are seen as the experts, those who are worthy of being given value and award are white people. How do I help? Some ways that people with white privilege feel like they're helping black people and people of color are through acts that come across as white saviorism. Movies like The Blind Side, The Help, The Great Wall really perpetuate white saviorist narratives. The example of The Great Wall, we have this story that's set in China, but the hero of the day is Matt Damon.
I'll give you the shot.
This is mainstream media, and the narratives that we are seeing is it doesn't matter what culture it is, it doesn't matter where these people come from, it's white people who are going to swoop in and save the day.
Okay, so what allyship looks like, feels like, and sounds like. It looks like amplifying the voices of the unheard, understanding that your education is up to you and no one else, and also owning up to any past mistakes you may have made. It feels like standing up, even if you are scared, taking on the struggles as your own, acknowledging that the conversation may not be about you, and it sounds like attentive listening, using inclusive language, and finally, speaking up to those beyond your social circle.
At the same time, all the corruption and justice, the same crimes, always a problem. If we do or don't fight and we die, we don't have the same right. What is a gun to a man that surrenders? What's it gonna take for someone to defend her? If we all agree that we're equal as people, then why can't we see what is evil? I can't breathe. Taking my life from me, I can't breathe. Will anyone fight for me? How do we cope when we don't love each other? Where is the hope and the empathy? How do we judge off the color? The structure was made to make us the enemy. Praying for change cause the pain makes you tender. All of the names you refuse to remember. But somebody's brother, friend or son to a mother that's crying.
Let's start from the beginning. Black Lives Matter, also known as BLM, is a decentralized political and social movement protesting against incidents of police brutality and all racially motivated violence against Black people. In July 2013, the movement began with the use of the hashtag Black Lives Matter on social media after the acquittal of George Zimmerman in the shooting death of African-American teen Trayvon Martin, 17 months earlier in February 2012. Using these stats, it's actually pretty recent. the movement became nationally recognized for street demonstrations. And of course, this hashtag and social demonstrations have been used loudly ever since. The movement returned to national headlines and gained further international attention during the global George Floyd protest in 2020, following the killing of George Floyd by a Minneapolis police officer, Derek Chauvin. An estimated 50 million to 26 million people participated in the 2020 Black Lives Matter protests in the United States, making it one of the largest movements in the country's history. The movement comprises of many views and a broad array of demands, but they center on justice reform.
So how far Black Lives Matter actually reaches? In the media, we tend to see one concept, one layer of this really large and huge concept. So as we're here today, Black Lives Matter includes, but is not limited to, constructing strong communities, proper representation, the ability to access mental health resources, focusing on health inequalities, the school-to-prison pipeline system, strong voices, and education. So remember, when speaking up about Black Lives Matter, educate yourself about these important topics and concepts.
I'll be introducing Lydia Collins, an Ottawa-based artist, activist, and educator. Lydia Collins will be reading her poem, Black Abundance.
Promise me, if I die at the hands of white supremacy, you will check on my mama before anything else. Do not circulate my final moments. Do not share pictures of my lifeless body. Please don't march for me. Your legs are tired enough as is. Preserve your strength for another day when you might need it to save yourself. If anything, let this be more reason to love us even harder, to hold us even tighter. Remember me by spreading Kesey's words that everyone Black was in some way abundant. Earthside or otherwise, everyone Black is in some way abundant. Promise me you'll check on my mama. Promise me her fridge will be full. Thank you.
Excellent. Black excellence. You're out here. Embrace our history, our heritage, our melanin.
So what does Black excellence look like? It's when Black individuals are doing extraordinary work to better their community and society as a whole, and being unapologetically you and proud. What does it feel like? It's empowering. It's joy. Because Black joy is an act of resistance and an example of Black excellence. What does it sound like? It's when you use your voice to uplift others, speaking your mind and saying your piece despite opposition and barriers. It's laughter. Trey Anthony. Trey Anthony is a creative artist who uses the unique combination of comedy, theater, motivational speech, and experiences from her own life to inspire and uplift others. She is a professional speaker, lifestyle coach, producer, author, and award-winning playwright. She gives Black women the no-nonsense tools to take control of their lives and prosper through art, humor, and the power of a clear message. Khalil Seabright. Khalil Seabright is a carpenter from Toronto who creates small wooden shelters for unhoused individuals. During the COVID-19 pandemic, Seabright said he built the shelters as a temporary solution to provide warm spaces for unhoused people in the winter so they can find alternative housing. With each shelter comes a smoke and carbon monoxide detector and a fire extinguisher. Keosha Love. Keosha Love is a multidisciplinary musician, organizer, and educator intersecting art and well-being in BIPOC communities to foster good health and mental well-being and inspire women. Keosha is a writer and filmmaker who advocates healing, racial justice, and social change by addressing the different stories and experiences of Black folks and communities of color. Karina Evans. Karina Evans might not be a household name just yet, but you've definitely seen the 24-year-old actor and director's work before. She's joined forces with fellow Torontonian Drake. Heard of him? On his music video for songs like God's Plan and Nice for What, along with directing videos for SZA and Coldplay. As the first woman to win the Prism Prize Lipset Award, recognizing music video creators, it's clear she will continue to push boundaries. Andre DeGrasse.
DeGrasse, born in Scarborough, won the silver medal in the 200 meter and bronze medals in both the 100 meter and 4x100 meter relay at the 2016 Summer Olympics in Rio de Janeiro. DeGrasse is also the founder of the Andre DeGrasse Family Foundation, ADGFF, will be a public charitable foundation committed to empowering and inspiring youth through sports and education.
Been traveling these wide roads so long. My heart's been far from you, 10,000 miles gone. Oh, I wanna come near and give you every part of me, but there's blood on my hands and my lips are unclean. In my darkness I remember mama's words that reoccurred to me. Surrender to the good Lord and he'll wipe your slate clean. Take me to your river, I wanna go. Go on, take me to the river, I wanna know. Dip me in your smooth waters, I go in. As a man with many crimes, come up for air. As my sins flow down the Jordan, oh, I wanna come here and give you every part of me. But there's blood on my hands and my lips are unclean. So take me to the river, I wanna go. Go on, take me to the river, I wanna know.
Sing, originally by J. Rosamond Johnson and James Weldon Johnson, and will be sung by me, Jenilyn Gray, is a song that has been named the Black National Anthem.
First written as a poem during the crucial time of Jim Crow, it was then shortly set to music. Because of the recent events of the death of George Floyd and Breonna Taylor, the Black Lives Matter protests, racial injustice, and the overall overcoming of these challenges, this song is about empowering each other and not be shaken by those who oppress us.
Lift every voice and sing, till the earth and heaven ring, ring with the harmonies of liberty. Let our rejoicing rise high as the listening skies. Let it resound loud as the rolling sea. Sing a song full of the faith that the dark past has taught us. Sing a song full of the hope that the present has brought us. Facing the rising sun of our new day begun, let us march on to victory is won. Stony the road we trod, bitter the chastening rod, felt in the days when hope unborn had died, yet with a steady beat have not our weary feet come to the place for which our Father sighed. We have come over a way with tears that has been watered. We have come treading our path through the blood of the slaughtered, out from the gloomy past, till now we stand at last where the white gleam of our bright star is cast. God of our weary years, God of our silent tears, thou who has brought us thus far on the way, thou who has by thy might led us into the light, keep us forever in the path, we pray. Lest our feet stray from the places, our God, where we met thee. Lest our hearts, drunk with the wine of the world, we forget thee. Shadowed beneath thy land, may we forever stand true to our God, true to our native land.
Yay!
The
rhythm to us. Freedom is like religion to us. Justice is juxtaposition in us. Justice for all just ain't specific enough. One son died, his spirit is revisiting us. True and living, living in us. Resistance is us. That's why Rosa sat on the bus. That's why we walked through Ferguson with our hands up. When it go down, we woman and man up. They say stay down, and we stand up. Shots, we on the ground, the camera panned up. King pointed to the mountaintop, and we ran up.
One day, when the glory comes, it will be out. It will be out. Oh, one day, when the war is won, we will be sure. We will be sure. Oh, glory. Oh, now the war is not over, victory isn't won, but we'll fight on to the finish, and then when it's all done, we'll cry glory, oh glory.
And gentlemen, beautiful job today, so gentlemen, also.
We'll cry glory, oh glory.
Every man, woman, and child. Even Jesus got his crown in front of a crowd. They march with the torch, we gon' run with it now. Never look back, we done gone hundreds of miles. From dark roads, heroes, to become a hero. Facing the League of Justice, his power was the people. Enemy is lethal, a king became regal. Saw the face of Jim Crow under a bald ego. The biggest weapon is to stay peaceful, we sing. Our music is the cuts that we bleed through. Somewhere in the dream we had an epiphany. Now we right the wrongs in history. No one can win the war individually. It takes the wisdom of the elders and young people's energy. Welcome to the story we call victory. The coming of the Lord, my eyes have seen the glory.
One day, when the glory comes, it will be